day Be'ezat Hashem is actually a day where you could even say, and I'll explain why I'm saying this, Mo'adim L'Simcha. Why Mo'adim L'Simcha? Because today is Rosh Chodesh. Now, but yesterday, we spoke about how in older times, actually, they would celebrate Rosh Chodesh as a holiday like any other holiday. Where it's actually once a month, we get up and we do Alel and we do Musaf like it is a regular Chag. And actually, Chazal wanted to make it a regular Chag, but they canceled it in order to not bring a situation where people have another 2 days in the month where they're not able to work. But you know, but what is the concept of Rosh Chodesh? What is really behind the reasoning of once a month coming and doing this Alel and doing this festive day? So you know, Abotai, there's actually a very, very interesting, a deep explanation that I would love to share with everyone. You know, Abotai, first of all, everything in this world that we see has a spiritual meaning and actually has something that is behind this action that's being made. So you know, Abotai, would mention, if I'm not mistaken, it was on Tisha B'Av, a beautiful Zohar that actually explains the connection and the parents of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, where it says that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is compared to be what? The father, where the father is very tough on his kids, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu created another strength, which is called the Shekhinah. And the Shekhinah is what? The Shekhinah is like the mother of Israel. The Shekhinah is what protects Bnei Israel. The Shekhinah is like the wife of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, in different words of explaining. But the Shekhinah, like we just said, was created by what? By Hashem. Zohar Kadosh says, actually, that exact same thing is brought to the sun and to the moon. So you know, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is compared to what? He is the act of the sun. Where the sun has a lot of strength, and it shines its light on what?
Moon.
On the moon. And as a result, what does the moon do? It shines the light back on us. That is exactly, Rabotai, what happens with the Shekhinah. HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives strength to the Shekhinah to exist. And as we turn, HaKadosh Baruch Hu has the Shekhinah, that the Shekhinah could bring us protection in Beracha. So we know, Rabotai, that actually, and this we mentioned before Rosh Hashanah, where the Shekhinah that protects Bnei Israel and the protection that Bnei Israel hold as Jews, where when we say we have a Jewish protection, we have Jewish Ashkacha Patit, it's actually the Shekhinah that's called what? Levana. Moon. That what gives us our special exclusivity amongst all the nations is that we are protected by the Shekhinah called the moon. Now, that same act is put in our physical world, where we know that what the Zohar Kadosh says, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu keeps Bnei Israel protected by the moon, nachon? But the moon, le'at, slowly by slowly, every 30 days, its protection starts to lower down, the light of the moon starts to become smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, until it's almost barely seen. And when it's almost barely seen, towards the end of the month, what do? We get up as Bnei Israel, and we do Alel. And we do a big festival of Rosh Chodesh to renew that protection for the entire month. That actually Rosh Chodesh, we're celebrating the fact that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is protecting us and keeping us like children the way we are, and to renew that blessing for another month to come. And that's why Rabotai, Rosh Chodesh is so important. Because every Rosh Chodesh that we do, we bring Beracha for the entire month. That every single Rosh Chodesh that we pass, every time we do Alel, every time we make the Rosh Chodesh even more holy, what we are doing is we are just bringing more koach and feeding more that renewing of the protection and the blessing of Bnei Israel. And that's why, Rabotai, Rosh Chodesh is very, very, very important. Now, you know, Rabotai, maybe later on we'll do a shiur about this, but actually Rosh Chodesh is something that it is very, very important. Some would even say more important for the woman than for the men. Because the Zohar Kadosh says that actually the concept of the itchadshut, or the concept of the renewal, comes from what? Like we said, comes from what, Rabotai?
What?
The Shekhinah. And the Shekhinah is who for HaKadosh Baruch Hu? The wife of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So actually, there is a big significance specifically with the woman in Rosh Chodesh, more than the men. Well, that's why it's where a woman cannot do any melacha on Rosh Chodesh. On Rosh Chodesh, it's the halacha. Women are not allowed to work. Why? Because it is the day of when the itchatshut that comes from the nukva, from the woman's side. So that is why Rabotai is very important, and one day we will lengthen on this subject, because I think it's a very beautiful and important subject to have our hands dwelled in. So may HaKadosh Baruch Hu b'dat lavet Hashem give us a month full of ta'acha, atzlacha, b'slat ha'dishmai, and may HaKadosh Baruch Hu hear all our prayers and fulfill all our hearts' wishes. Amen.